I'm so glad I've been washed in your blood.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses.
Teach me how to pray.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord. The word of God says in Psalms 107, 1 through 2, oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. We have come today to give thanks unto our God, who has always been good. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. In every circumstance in your life, God has always been good. You will leave here with a deeper revelation of his goodness. In this service, you will experience his faithfulness to you. In this service, you will experience his love for you. In this service, you will experience how he has blessed you. In this service, you will experience how he has empowered you. In this service, you will experience how he has delivered you. In this service, you will experience how he has encouraged you. In this service, you will experience how he has shielded you. In this service, you will experience how he has anointed you. In this service, you will receive a revelation from Jesus the Christ. Let's celebrate this great God, Jesus.
I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. No matter what I see or how I feel, as long as I'm breathing, oh yes, I'm breathing, I'll bless the Lord. As long as I'm breathing, oh yes, I'm breathing, I'll bless the Lord. Father, have your way in this place. You be glorified in it all. Come on, let's raise it together. Say,
I will bless
and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. No matter what I see or how I feel, as long as I'm breathing, oh yes, I'm breathing, I'll bless the Lord. As long as I'm breathing, hey, oh yes, I'm breathing, I'll bless the Lord. Oh, magnify, oh, magnify. That's the reason why we're here tonight. Let's lay down our cries.
Been Come on, Timmy said, there is power in the name of Jesus. Oh, there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. Oh, to break every chain. Break every chain, break every chain. Break every chain, to break every chain, break every chain.
That's it, there is power.
There is power.
Come on.
In the name of Jesus.
Come on, you declare it.
There is
every chain.
Break every chain.
Come on, say it to me.
Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain.
There's an army rising up. There's an army rising up. There's an army rising up, yeah. To break every chain, break every chain.
There is power.
Come on.
In the name of Jesus.
Come on, army of the Lord, raise it.
There is power.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
There is power.
There is power.
In the name of Jesus. Just to break every chain. Yes, it will.
Ah!
Lord, if I find favor in your sight, Lord, please hear my heart's cry. I'm desperately waiting to be where you are. Across the hottest desert, I'll travel near or far for your glory. I will do anything just to see.
It's a new day. You need to receive. God said he's doing a new thing. It's a beginning. A new beginning. He said, change breaker. He is changing. He is shifting. He is realigning. Peacemaker. Peace be in your home. God said those loved ones that you know need peace, you need to call their names out even right now in this atmosphere. God said, I'm giving a new beginning. Hallelujah. Yesterday's manna won't fit for today. Hallelujah. He's bringing new manna, new rest, new refreshing. The cloud, the glory cloud, God says is dwelling even amongst you. Hallelujah. You just need to receive it. Hallelujah. This glory cloud is going to push back. Anything that's been hindering you. Hallelujah. I hear God say he's clearing the channel. There's a new strength coming. There's a new beginning. Hallelujah. It's propelling forth. Check it, yeah, baby. There's no holding back, say God. This is a new place in God. Hallelujah. And God said it is marvelous in his eyes. This is the Lord's doing. Hallelujah. This is the Lord's doing. Hallelujah. This is the Lord's doing. Hallelujah. And it is marvelous. It is marvelous in his eyes. Hallelujah. I see people like getting on a train. Hallelujah. You got a ticket in your hand, but you still looking at the ticket, like you're trying to make a decision. Oh, my God. You need to decide today. Are you on this train? Because this thing is going to blow your mind. And God say it's going to be signs, miracles, and wonders. Hallelujah. And he said it don't have nothing to do with us. He said, but his word, hallelujah, his word has gone before. And it is manifestation time. Hallelujah. He said, bring your mind into alignment. Bring your mind into alignment. It is manifestation time. He said, just because his word is out there. His word is on it. His name is on it. See, we're not glory stealers. Hallelujah. We're glory carriers. Hallelujah. And God is going to get his glory. Hallelujah. You need to sign, God, I'm going to give you the glory. I'm going to make room for you. I'm going to make room for you. This is your doing, God. And it is marvelous in our eyes, God. And we receive. See, sometimes God is trying to get something to you. And you can't receive it.
Yes.
And what he showed me packages with names on them. I'm going to get off this thing, but I hear God say, go ahead and tell it. I saw packages everywhere. It looked like when you walked outside, just packages everywhere, steps in front of people's houses. They had their name on it. What God say with that you've been wanting? It's already there.
Yes, God.
But what I saw was people was walking by, but only those in the eyes of the Spirit saw the packages with their name on it. So I pray that your eyes are enlightened. Get out of your flesh and tap into the spiritual things and stay there. God's got some great things in store for you. Hallelujah. You got to receive. Bishop was talking about it's a gift. Hallelujah. You got to receive the gift. And as you receive it, oh my God, how it's going to open. Oh my God, how it unveils. Hallelujah. And it's just not one level of gifts. What he showed me was big gifts, small gifts, huge gifts. Oh, no, boy, shake it up. And he didn't need, hallelujah, I didn't see no UPS man. Oh, my God. He just let me see the packages everywhere. So I choose to believe what God say. If it's manifestation time, God, we're going to get an alignment. We receive. It's manifestation time. So get your heart off, Lord, how long it's been. I don't ever hope. All I hear him say is believe again. Hallelujah. And after you believe it, God, we receive it. Hey, shut up a hope. And then we're going to give God all the glory. Hey, shut up a hope. We're going to share the good news. Hallelujah. We're going to tell the story. Hallelujah. How about the goodness of God. Hallelujah. I know it's wartime. Hallelujah. But I hear God say, this is a twofold thing. Shut up a hope. He got you those that have believed, those that have prevailed, those that have waited and trusted in God. He got, it's gonna be a glorious time in this earth. I don't know. He got you. I can't see a thing right now. I tell you, my eyes are blurred, and when it's blurred, I don't know. I got a revelation. Just say what the Lord say. Hey, shut up. He got shot. No, no, no. This is not about no flesh. Hallelujah. But we got to give God glory. Listen, those that have believing, don't give up on God now. If I don't do anything today, I want to encourage you, don't give up on the good Lord. Oh, my God. And those that have been longing and waiting, you have not compromised the gospel. Hallelujah. You stood fast. Hallelujah. Hold on to God's unchanging hand, because God got some good things in store for you. And if anything is coming up for your peace today, I pray right now that you kick it out the way. Hallelujah. You don't even live it. Don't give it no space. Hallelujah. Don't address no distractions. Keep your eyes on Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, my God. Be determined to trust him like never before. He got shot. Yes, the darkness don't come in the earth. But there's a light. Hallelujah. We got to know that the light is greater than darkness. Listen. He got up. God loves you so much. Listen.
Thank you, Lord.
What the devil's done don't mean nothing, honey, because the God's going to get the glory. He's going to have a greater story. Just hold on. Your story is going to be greater. The greater the test, the greater the testimony. Hallelujah. So come on, believe God today. Trust God today. Hallelujah. He was saying break every chain. He is the chain breaker. He got shot out of a hook. He created the man that made the chain. What you think? God can't break no chain. Change how you seeing this thing. Shift your perception. But you can only shift it in the Holy Ghost and God give you revelation. So listen, it's enough out there to try to bring you down. Come on and trust God and bring yourself up. It's not about us, hallelujah, but it's about what God is doing. Listen, on my worst day and my worst pain, I find myself giving God praise. Because all God can tell me is this: I love you. And I'm going to bring you out with victory. I love you. And I know you hurt me like a bad dog now, but don't just do what I tell you. So listen, just be determined to obey God. Get your eyes off your circumstances. And I hear God say he poured a new strength like a double oil on Bishop Smith. And I decree it right now in the name of Jesus. There's a healing, there's a restoration, there's a higher realm. There's a higher realm of glory. The greater the glory, the greater the story. And it is so, said God. We just get to the ground. It is so. And we receive it and we believe it. In Jesus' name, somebody ought to give God a praise. Hallelujah.
Let's everybody come off the meat and receive that word. And receive that word.
Thank you, Father, for loving me. Thank you, Lord.
Before we do the declaration, wait a minute, we need to praise him some more. I mean, praise.
God has spoken to us this morning. We need to give him a real praise. Yes. Whether it's through song or we need to praise him. Yes, we need to praise him.
Hallelujah.
Jesus, only Jesus. Uh-huh. Love Ministries, this is the decade of pay, and we can have what we say we can have. Let's prepare to declare our decrees for the decade of pay. Decrees are available in the chat, and you may remain on mute and repeat after me. Love Ministries, therefore, we decree that 5784 is our year to advance. It is the year for my family is saved. It is our year of overflow. It is our year of victory. It is our year of big moves and surprises. It is our year of increase and wealth. It is our year to live as financial giants. It's our year to overcome all limitations. It's our year to walk through great and precious doors. It is our year to walk in accurate discernment. It is our year to possess our possessions. It is our year to occupy my rightful place of prominence. This is our year of notable miracles. How many really believe these decrees? Seal them with a thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We say thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Love Ministries, our bishop always puts us in good hands. Please receive our very own Prophet Ro as she delivers the word today.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give you praise, God. We recognize who you are, Father. You are awesome. You are the great I am, God. We receive every word, God. Every word that you have spoken, God. You are great. You are the great I am. You are with us in the beginning. You're with us in the end, Father. We give you praise today. God, there's nothing that is too hard for you, God. We honor you, God. Oh, we taste and see that you are good, God. Not sometimes, but you are good all the time, God. We thank you that there is power in your name, God. There is power in your name, Father. And we give you praise for it right now, Father God. Father God, we thank you right now for our Pastor Bishop Still. We thank you for what you're doing in her life, God. We thank you for blessing from the top of her head to the sole of her feet, God. We thank you, oh, she got that cold, my heart. For preparing this word, God, to bless, to edify, God. And we give you praise for it, Father God. And we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. And we say, amen, amen. I am. God is saying that he's still the great I am. I am. He said, receive all my words that have gone forth, because I am. I am. I was in the beginning. I will be at the end. I am the great I am. Receive my words like never before. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, God. Ah, oh, shit, kid, that I'm a hot. Oh, I taste and see. Come on. Taste and see that he's good all the time. Not sometimes, but he's good all the time. Father, we thank you and we praise you. There is power in the name of Jesus. Huh? And he will and he have. I hear you, God. Break every chain. But he needs some people to believe who he is. Huh? He needs some people to believe that he is the great I am and he can break every chain. Hallelujah. See, I don't know if anyone is aware, but everything wants to come before us and take number one position, the number one place in our minds. Amen. Any struggle, any problem, any issues, whatever we may be going through, it wants to come and sit and rest upon our minds. It wants to take first place. Do y'all hear me? Hell yeah, yeah. See, I remember Bishop just preached on our minds and saying that we have to position ourselves over our mind. We got to take position over our mind, amen? So I have some students, y'all, that come in and tell me, you know, as a counselor, I have little sessions going. And I have some students that come in and want to tell me, hey, I'm having some negative thoughts, Miss Rowe. I'm having some unhappy thoughts right now. But you know, I tell them often in our session, I wish I had control over your mind. I wish I did. But you have control over your own mind. You got to redirect your mind right now and tell your mind where to go and what to think. Amen? See, they are quiet for a moment, but then they think about that thing and say, oh, yeah, I do have position over my mind. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So it's time, y'all, for us to use our methods, some of our devices to change our mindsets. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. See, I don't know about y'all, but my device It's the word of God. My method is prayer. I don't know. What's your method today? What's your device today? Amen. Now, see, our Father, God was speaking to me. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. About having first place in our mind. Amen. In our spirits and in our souls. We have to make sure that we position ourselves to allow God to take first place. Amen. Now, this is the season. I don't know if you know it or not, but this is the season that we have to put the first things first. I'm not talking about a car. I'm not talking about a Cadillac right now. I'm not talking about a Lexus right now. I'm talking about putting the first things first. And the first thing first is God, I say, amen? Now, I know it sounds like a cliche. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. We say it so much. But God is asking today, where is the action? Where is the action today? Amen? Come on, I want y'all to follow along with me. Amen? Come on, turn into your Bibles to Genesis. Amen? First book in the Bible. Amen? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. God is good. First book in the Bible. Genesis, I'm going to take 1 and 2. Amen? First this. I'm reading from Message. Amen? First this. God created the heavens and earth. All you can see and all you don't see. Earth was a soup of nothingness. Amen? Oh, y'all know when you're talking about a soup, you're talking about a lot of ingredients. But when you put something in soup, you're looking for a good taste. Amen? But in this, in this incident, God says a soup of nothingness. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. So how much you add, it came out to nothing. Amen? So he says a bottomless emptiness, an inky blackness. God's spirit brooded like a bird above the watery abyss. Look at this. But God was about to make changes. He didn't like the way things was going. You better think about your life. But God was about to make changes. Look at your life. There's some stuff going on our life. Oh, my God. God does not like what he's seeing. But he's about, to make some changes in our lives. Amen? So the world was nothing. God was watching. He was hovering. Saw things need to be changed. And guess what he did? And he spoke. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. And God said, let there be. And all creation started. But when he created man, look at this thing, y'all. But when he created man, I'm going somewhere. But when he created man, came out in his image. He even breathed life, into man. Now that breath, that breath of God made Adam a living soul. He made him capable of knowing God, enjoying God. See, I don't know about y'all, but this right here, it tells me that God thinks I'm special. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. See, now if God took the time to make us special, when are we going to make God special in our eyes? Uh-huh. See, he came first. We can't forget that. When do we realize that God needs to be placed first? See, there's so much stuff going on in this world, but God took out the time to say, put me first. He didn't have to. Amen? Okay, now see, the way things are going right now, God gets no credit and no recognition unless he's being blamed for something, the state of the world. The problems that we're having, day-to-day problems. See, whether we can see it or not, God is speaking. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Whether we can see it, whether we can hear it, God is speaking. Amen? Now, see, God is hovering. Oh, yeah, yeah. He's watching. Oh, my God. Looking at our destruction. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I know we don't want to hear about destruction, but he's looking at our destruction. But now he's waiting on us to speak something. Amen? See, remember, God breathed life in us. So we have access now to have a relationship with God. Access to speak to him. Oh, yeah, yeah. He's waiting, y'all, on us to know without a doubt that he's El Shaddai. He's waiting on us to know without a doubt that he's the creator. He's waiting on us to know without a doubt that he is the healer. He is Jehovah Nisi. He is Jehovah. Oh, my God. He is Jehovah. Oh, shit. Now, see, the way the world is operating, God is looking at his children and asking, what position do I possess in the lives of my children right now? Yeah. Do my children, what do they think of me right now? Oh, yeah. Who and what do they think I am? Oh, my God. See, God wants to know today. I hope we got an answer for him. Are my people loving what the world loves? Do we have an answer? Are my people chasing what the world does right now? Yeah. Are my people living, like the world? What's the answer today? What's your answer today? Amen. See, God is asking today, am I first on your list? When you get up in the morning, am I first? Throughout the day, am I first? Or am I only need-based? Oh, yeah. When trouble comes, I know the Creator. Oh, yeah. When I'm sick, my healer is coming forth. But where have we placed him? Is he last on the list, or is he first on the list? See, I came to tell you, I hope you're getting this thing. Money didn't come first. Oh, I know we need it. See, families didn't come first. And for some of us, food did not come first. See, we rely on different things as a crutch. God came first. That's what he's saying. I am saying to my people this day that I am the Creator. Oh, my God. See, the word that he said, I am the Creator. Those who believe in me, those who set me first, I am the Creator. And I do bless, and I do perform miracles like no other time. Oh, yeah. See, I don't know if y'all know it, but God is the total package. Oh, yeah. He is lacking nothing. Oh, my God. He is the healer. He's the finance resource. He's the restorer. He's the mind regulator. I don't know if we know it, but he's all that wrapped up into one package. Amen. See, God knows y'all. He knows that there will be other things in our lives. He knows that we're not going to speak in tongues 24/7. He knows that there's other things in our lives that will try to monopolize our time, our energy, our peace, and our love. Oh, yeah. He knew, y'all, that we would have relationships. He knew that we would have families. He put Adam and Eve. He created them. He knew that we would have homes. He put them in the Garden of Eden. Amen. He knew that we would have incidents that would try to block our relationship with him. He knew that stuff and things, would try to take over his number one position. Oh, yeah. But I'm here to tell you, God had a plan. He had an escape plan for us. By the name of Jesus. He had a plan by the name of repentance. He had a plan by the name of forgiveness. Amen. Oh, my God. Come on. I want you to turn to me. I got a word for you. Come on. Turn with me. John 3. And we got to go 17 to 18. Amen. He had a plan. Amen. This is how much God loved the world. He gave his son, his one and only son. Oh, yeah. And this is why. So that no one need to be destroyed. By believing in him, anyone can have, a whole and lasting life. God didn't go to all the trouble of sending his son merely to point an accusing finger, telling the world how bad it was. He came to help to put the world right again. Amen? Oh, my God. See, y'all know I work in the school setting. Amen? Oh, yeah. And see, students strive, taking advanced courses, participating in extracurricular activities, football, tennis, student council, amen? Trying to get to the number one position. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. See, our number one position at our school is called the valedictorian, which means first in the class. See, there are benefits to being number one, amen? Now, but see, but God today wants to know, how are we striving? And what are we doing to put him in the number one position? Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. See, we want to strive in the world setting. Oh, yeah, I hope y'all listen to me. We want to strive in the world setting. See, we want to be number one with the best car. Nothing wrong with it. We want to be number one with that education. Oh, yeah, that's my strive. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. We want to be we want to have the best shape. We want to have the best features. Oh, yeah, we want to be number one. But see, we don't understand that when we make him number one, we come on up to the number one position. Oh, y'all ain't saying that. Oh, we come on up to the number one position. Amen? Mm-hmm. See, he already placed us in that number one position, y'all, when he allowed his son to be sacrificed for me and you. Amen? But see, sometimes we get lax. And we forget that God is number one. We forget all the words that he has spoken into our lives. We forget that he's able to perform what he said. Amen? Now, see, there are some benefits, y'all. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. See, there are some benefits in putting God first. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. He gave us salvation. I don't know about y'all, but that's important for me. My benefit is grace. My benefit is favor. My benefit is mercy. My benefit is his love, his peace, his forgiveness, his blessings. Oh, we cannot forget his miracles. Oh, my God, my God, my God. See, God sacrificed much for us, y'all, when he gave us his son. He sacrificed his son. What more could you ask a wonderful, loving God? Amen? See, when we put God first, our joy is established in our lives. I think Bishop preached on that some weeks ago. Joy. Not the world's joy, but God's joy. Amen? It's established in our lives. Amen? See, but when we set up anything above God in our life, we are setting up idols. Amen? And we all know the Ten Commandments. Oh, yeah, Exodus 20:33. You shall have no other gods before me. And then he went on to tell us in John, 1 John 5:21. Dear children, keep yourselves from idols. Amen? I'm telling you right now, that word stuck with me from prophet. God is going to do what he said. But he has to be number one in our lives. Amen? He cannot just be a thought, a backward thought. Amen? He has to be number one. I want you to think right now. Where is God? Where is he ranked right now in your life? Think about even this morning when we got up, when we was awakened by God. What was our first thought? Was it him? Thank you, Father, for waking me up. Think about these things. I'm telling you, when we make him first, y'all, everything will be added. Amen? Yeah. See, sometimes when we think about idols, I'm going back to that. We're thinking about, oh, money, this, that, what have you. We put things before God. But God was speaking to me. He said a lot of times, my children don't understand, but they put their problems, they place their problems as idols, sickness as idols. Anything you focus on more than me, says God. Amen? And God is saying there's nothing wrong with blessings. There's nothing wrong with riches, money, nothing. But anything that you place before me, I'm a jealous guy. Anything that you place before me is an idol. Amen? See, when we put God first, it gives us a solid foundation, y'all. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. You know, let me tell you what a solid foundation would do. Anytime any wind blows, any problem winds, finance winds blows in our life, we'll be still standing. But when we don't have that solid foundation, anything will make us go astray. Any problem that comes up against us will make us go astray. And I'm here to tell you, when we don't have that solid foundation, any prophecy that we have gotten, amen, and we have not prayed on that prophecy and placed it in our heart, any prophecy that has not, oh shit, kid, that am I.
Prophet Ro, can you unmute yourself?
Any prophecy that we get and it has not manifested, it will make the wind blow in our lives. Amen? Hallelujah. Building a solid foundation. Amen? See, when we put God first, everything that we need will fit into our lives. When we put God first, everything that we need will fit into our lives. Joy, peace, love, family, homes, vehicles, everything. Because 1 Thessalonians says it best, y'all. Come on. 1 Thessalonians 2 and 4. As we live to please God, he promises to bless our lives and make us prosper. When you decide to serve God with your whole heart and make him first in your life, your soul will prosper and your joy and your peace will increase. Hallelujah. Putting God first. Put the first things first. Amen? Putting God first. He's ready to bless like no other time. There are some changes that are coming into our lives like never before. And see, it sounds like a cliche, y'all. God speaks changes all the time. But God is looking and he's asking, where do I fit into your lives? It's time for us to make him first like no other time. Amen? And then the Lord says, when we put him first, he will direct our path. See, I don't know about y'all, but there have been some times in my life where I didn't know which way I was going. Going to the left, going to the right, this way, that way. But the word of God says when you place him first, he will direct our path. Amen? Proverbs 3, look at this, 5-6 tells us, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. All your ways submit to him and he will make your path straight. Hallelujah. He will make your path straight. Amen. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father. Thank you for making our path straight right now as we put you first, as we put you as number one. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want everybody, if you would, turn to me to 1 Kings. Amen. 1 Kings 17. Amen. God is speaking. 1 Kings 17. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I'm going to paraphrase if you just follow along with me. Amen. Elijah, this is about Elijah and the widow woman. Amen. So Elijah reminded a widow of what would happen if she placed God first. Now, God told Elijah, look at this, in 1 Kings 17 and 8, to arise and go to Zarephath. He said, I have told a widow to provide for you. Amen? See, during a time of famine, the prophet Elijah visited a town where he met a widow. Amen? Just follow along with me. Amen? Who was preparing a final meal for herself and her son. Amen? Now, Elijah asked her for some bread and water, and the widow explained that she only had enough, amen, for one meal only. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. And after that was gone, she would face starvation, amen. Now, see, Elijah persisted. Oh, I'm so glad she had somebody to persist in her life. It's good to have somebody persist in your life, amen, to remind you over and over, amen. So Elijah persisted. Don't be afraid. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. But first, make me a small meal, amen? Oh, my God, my God. A small loaf of bread for me from what you have and bring it to me, and then make something for yourself and your son, amen? So Elijah told her, this is what the Lord says, uh-huh. The bowl of flour shall not be exhausted, nor shall the jar of oil be emptied until the day that the Lord sends rain again on the face of the earth. See, Elijah was telling her, y'all, if you just put God first, yeah, 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 he won't let you down. Okay, come on, somebody take that in. If you just put God first, he won't let you down. I don't care if you've been waiting on that prophecy for years. I don't care if you've been waiting on something for years. If you just put God first, I assure you that he won't let you down. Now, Elijah was sent, y'all, to change her mentality from the natural to the supernatural. I'm here to tell you, he was sent to change her from the natural to the supernatural, amen? He was sent to prepare her for her miracles. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. See, when we get prophecy after prophecy, y'all don't understand. That's just a preparation for your miracle, amen? I'm telling you right now, oh, she got that kid, my heart. Believe the prophet. Echo those shit, kid, that my heart. It's just a setup for your miracle right now. I'm telling you right now, Brandon, I echo shit, kid, my heart. You're getting set up for your miracle. If you believe the word of the Lord, you're getting set. I don't care how many times some stuff has been going on and on. God said, get ready, for I'm preparing a miracle right now at your feet, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. See, the enemy in flesh wants us to believe sometimes that this miracle that God is speaking is too big, it's too large. But God said, am I not the God who created the heavens and the earth? Am I not the God who parted the Red Sea? I am able to do what I have, what I have said, says the Lord. See, there are some things, I know where I am, but I hear God. There are some things that's going to happen, to God's people, no matter what. We know it's a war going, we know what's going on in the world, but God said, I am bigger. I am larger than that. When will my people start to believe that I am God, of outstanding measures? Oh, my God, my God, my God. Next, I hear God say, you ain't seen nothing yet. Oh, yeah, God said, I'm positioning you like no other time. Oh, shit, to flourish. He said, I know what position you're in. I am not a mere man, but I am positioning you to flourish. He said, oh, you shall flourish in your education. Oh, yeah, that's what he's saying. He said, you shall flourish, and you shall prosper with money, says the Lord of hosts. Receive the word of the Lord and watch what he does in your life. Oh, of course, my God, my God, my God. Speak, God. Oh, God is repositioning some things in your personal life, some things that you have just told him about. God said, look unto me. I shall manifest in days, says God. God said, I shall manifest in days. He said, he knows everything that you have. Oh, every subject matter that you have brought into the heavens. So, and he said, watch, for I am moving like no other time, for you have positioned me as number one. Thank you, Father. Receive the word of the Lord. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Echo do se kid de la maha. He knows that you have repositioned and changed into another position. That's a job. I hear you, God. He said, but that's nothing. Oh, shit, kid, that I'm a hop. Watch what I, oh, shit, kid, that I'm a hop. Watch where I take your life. Watch where I take you to. Thank you, Father. Receive the word of the Lord. Receive the word of the Lord. Receive the word of the Lord today. Hallelujah. Sending the natural. Sending you up from the natural to the supernatural. From the natural to the supernatural. I'm here to tell you, it doesn't matter how things look. Oh, yeah. It doesn't matter how it looks. I'm telling you, God is repositioning some things. Doesn't matter how it looks. God is repositioning some minds right now. He's repositioning some health issues right now. Oh, shit, God, the local sick. Anyway, by faith, I hear you, Father. By faith, the widow obeyed. I don't know about y'all, but see, obedience take you up to the first. By faith, the widow obeyed. She put God first and fed the prophet. And then came the miracle. Did y'all hear that? She put God first, obeyed the prophet, and then came the miracle. Oh, my God, my God. See, the miracle, there was food every day for Elijah and for the woman and her family. For the jar of flour was not used up, and the jug of oil did not run dry. Thank you, Father. See, you think, if you read this, you think one thing is going on, but God is operating a twofold blessing. That's just like with us. See, you think one thing is going on in your life, but God is operating on five or six of your things in your life. See, you think he's blessing you with one thing, but out of that blessing, there are two and three, four and five blessings that's coming for you. Y'all better be getting this. Oh, yeah. See, you asked him for one thing, but he knows how to operate and bless you with five or six at one time, because he's not a mere man. He's supreme. He's El Shaddai. Oh, shit, kid, that I'm a hot. Oh, yeah. I know where I am. See. Oh, my God. He's operating a twofold blessing right now. See, God, if you read that whole chapter, y'all, God was hiding Elijah. You better read it. Yeah. See, his life was in danger. Oh, yeah. Elijah was running, y'all. But he wasn't running by himself. Mm-hmm. Yeah. See, Elijah had prophesied a drought, and that was the threat against the reign of Ahab. Well, my God. Elijah, see, he didn't argue with God when he told him to prophesy. Oh, my God. And then he told him to get up and go to another city. Mm-hmm. He didn't ask him, why am I going there? How are you going to protect me? How are you going to feed me if I do what you say? He didn't ask all those extra questions, amen? See, he placed God first. He trusts and believed that God's word were true and God's words would produce. The words that we have got, do we believe that those words produce? Or do we just give up on the words after even a year is passed? Do we just believe that God's words are in vain? Amen? See, I can relate, y'all, to Elijah running. Oh, yeah. Yes, I can. Scared after he prophesied. Oh, yeah, sometimes. See, sometimes when God tell me to prophesy, in my mind I'm saying, really, God? You know they're not going to receive from me. Really, God? But let me tell y'all something. In that 1 second, that goes. Because I don't know about y'all, but see, I would rather face a non-receiving, angry person than a disappointed God. Because I'm going to do whatever my God say. If you receive it, so be it. Amen. I want him proud or wonder. Amen. Hallelujah in the house. Amen. And anyway, then the widow lady was stopped by God, El Shaki, before she was about to do it her way. Oh, aren't you glad sometimes when you're in the midst of doing stuff your way, you can hear God's voice. When you're in the midst of telling somebody off, you stop because you can hear God's voice. In the middle of you going bad, it's when you know you don't smoke, you can hear it. Oh, You can hear it, oh man, before she did it her way, amen? Before she agreed to cook Elijah, before she agreed to cook him that meal, amen? See, y'all think about this thing, amen? See, you just got enough flour just to make you and yours a meal. And somebody comes up and say, hey, Wanda, why don't you fix me a meal? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Why don't you fix me a meal? Uh-huh. See, I would have to think about that thing because first thing sometimes you go to the flesh, amen? Mm-hmm. Thinking, oh, you know, I just got to satisfy me and mine first. Oh, yeah. Me and mine come first before anything. See, we sometimes place God on the back burner when flesh intervenes, amen? And we put our circumstances in the way of God. See, think about when you know we know we have to pay, we pay our tithes, y'all, but there's a bill due. Which one should I do? But we know which one is going to benefit us more, the Lord, because there's abundance and doing and being obedient to the Lord. Amen? Oh, yeah. Now, see, not only did God provide that time for the widow lady, but he provided for the widow lady when her son died. If you would read on down. And her son was brought back to life. Amen? See, whether we know it or not, God does not forget us, y'all. He knows when we have placed him first. Amen? Come on, just follow with me. I'm almost finished. Just continue to follow me for a little moment. Now, if we had a scale, if we run a scale, let's see where we would rate with God, amen? I'm asking now, if we had a scale from 1 to 5, where would God be in your life? Listen to this. If we're number 1 on that scale, that means we're believing God is all powerful, all knowing. He can do all things but fail. And that's when we have a relationship with God. Who's at the number 1 rate right now? Ephesians 3:20. Now glory be to God, who by his mighty power at work within us is able to do far more than we could ever dare to ask or even dream of. Amen. Ooh, but yearn our highest prayers, desires, thoughts, or hopes. Who's at number 1? Let's go on to number 2. Who would rate at number 2? Come on, think about this as I'm reading. We believe in that God has covered me 90% of the time. Some things I don't have to bother God with because I already know what he would say. Who's at number 2? Matthew 6:38. And he would give them to you if you give him first place in your life and live as he wants you to. But then we're going to rating number 3. Come on, think about those things. I can feel him sometimes, number 3. Mm-hmm. He comes when I need him sometimes. He's 75% on time. But I ask my friends to pray for me. They get better results than me. Psalms 18:6. In my distress, I screamed to the Lord for his help, and he heard me from heaven. My cry reached his ears. Where are we? Think about number 1, 2, or 3. Are we on Zoom? Nobody has to see us. Think on those things. Then we get to number 4. Oh, I call on him when I'm in desperate need. I say a quick prayer. He doesn't answer me quickly. I get frustrated, confused because he won't answer. Oh my God. John 15:5. Yes, I am the vine. You are the branches. Whoever lives in me and I in him shall produce a large crop of fruit. For apart from me, you can't do a thing. And then we're going to mosey on to number five. What is your rating this morning? Well, number five, I haven't really communicated with God. I just cried and tried to do it my way. I turned to friends. I turned to drinks. I turned to food. That kind of helps me along the way. I just take my mind off God. And I take my mind off the problem. But Second Peter comes forth. He isn't really being slow about his promised return, even though it sometimes seems that way. But he is waiting for the good reason that he is not willing that any should perish. Amen? And he is giving more time for sinners to repent. I want you to think about those ratings. Oh, yeah. And it might seem like, oh, no one's like that. Yes, somebody is like that. Where do we fit in with God's rate? Amen? Think about it. Where do you rate? 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5? Amen? It's time, no matter what, guys, to put the first things first, which is God. Amen? Which is our Savior, which is El Shaddai, which is Jehovah Nissi, our Creator, our beginning, and our end. Amen? Put God first. God has everything outlined for his people right now. He has a plan for each and every one of us. He's waiting on us, even though the world seems to be going astray. God is not astray. He's waiting on us to put him first. He already put us first when he gave his son on that cross. So now is the time for us to recognize that he is God all by himself. Amen? Hallelujah. Amen? It's time, guys. It's time to place him first. Now, we have not made God first in our lives. Think about if God is really first. When do we think about God? Only in miserable, when we're going through miserable times? Only when we're going through trouble? When do we exercise our praise and our worship unto God? Amen? So if you have not made God your first, this is the time. Let's repent. Let's repent. If we have not made God first in even situations that we're going through, let's repent right now. Father God, we repent right now. We thank you right now for receiving us like no other time. God, we thank you. As we turn around our lives right now, we repent and we make you first, God. If we have replaced you, Father God, if we have replaced you with material things, God, anything that we have even placed as idols before you, we repent right now. We change our minds. We turn our minds back to you right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We turn our minds back to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Receive, Father, like no other time. Receive our repentance, God, like no other time. Thank you, Father. Anything that we have placed in front of you, anything, we repent right now. We ask for your forgiveness. We ask for your forgiveness right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Again, I say, if we have not made God first in our lives, this is the day to make that change. Amen? If God has been replaced with something else, if he has been forgotten, if he has been placed on a shelf, it's time to renew our relationship with God right now. Amen? Today, just confess to God right now. Let's believe and confess with our mouth right now and our hearts that Jesus is the Son of God. Amen? Come on, let's believe that Jesus died on the cross for our sins right now, and that he rose again, and he's sitting right now on the right hand of our Father, our God. Amen? Come on, ask God to forgive our sins right now. Come on, come on. And ask him to come into our heart right now. That's a change that's coming forth. That's a change that's coming forth. When you make God first, that's a change that's coming. That's a change coming. God is revamping some things in our life like never before. Amen? Just make him first. Come on. Everybody just say, God, I make you first. Come on. Just tell him, God, I make you. Come on. God, I make you first. Put the first things first. God, I make you first. Even when we make a mistake, we change it. Come on. That's repentance. That's forgiveness. God, I make you first right now. Come on. God, I make you first. Amen. Come on, God, I make you first. Come on, come on, come on, come on, unmute yourself. Come on, I want everybody to unmute. Come on, God, I make you first. Come on, God, I make you first.
God, I make you first.
God, I make you
first. God, I make you first.
God, I make you first.
God, I make you first.
Get all the sins.
God, I make you first.
God, I make you first.
Too many things that has taken first place.
God, I make you first.
Every situation, every
circumstance. God, I make you first in my life, Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. We praise you right now, God. We honor you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. I make you first in my life.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
God is looking. Thank you, man is not. It doesn't matter.
Yes, Jesus.
God is looking.
Yes.
Judith, I heard God. God said, when you make me first in every situation, I'm developing. I'm developing in you like never before. He said, my development, it's patience. My development in you is showing you how much I love you. My development in you, is forgiveness, says God. God said, anything that you are asking, at this time, God said, I shall do, but I want to be first. Job is not first. Family is not first. I am first, says God. And watch what I do in your life. Everything that is trying to reign havoc in your life, God says destroy. Believe the word of the Lord and watch what God does. Receive the word of the Lord. God said, I am not slack and I am not slow. Anything that seems like it's out of whack, I hear you, God, has to come into formation, says God. Don't you know that I am the creator and I make crooked things and crooked ways straight? Believe the word of the Lord and watch.
I receive it.
Says God.
I receive it. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
God is not slack. He is not slack. And he is not too slow in your life. He's revamping some things in your life, Shelby. I don't care if you heard it over and over again. God is revamping some things in your life. And even some things that you have not even thought about, God said, I'm straightening it out because I am that Lord. You shall prosper and you shall be in good health, says God. I have need of you. You shall prosper and you shall be in good health. Receive the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 I hear God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, we give you praise, God. Hallelujah. We give you praise right now, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, shake that in my heart. Answers. God said, I did not lie. I shall manifest what I have said, says God. Man will lie to you, but I, thy God, do not lie. Continue to place me first. And you watch what I do. There are some prophecies that have been years old, says God. I am not finished. I know when to come. Right on time. Read my words and watch it prosper, my children.
Hallelujah.
You might say in your spirit, if I hear one more about money. One more.
Oh my God.
But God said, you better believe the prophet.
Yes, God.
And you shall prosper, says God.
Yes, Lord.
You believe the word.
Thank you, Lord. Yes. Receive it.
I'm not slack. I'm not slow, says God. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
We give you praise.
Thank you, Lord. Yes, God.
Right now.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. You know that's not the y'all know that's not your last house. Get ready for decoration. Get ready to decorate, says the Lord of hosts.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm not slack. Oh, shit, says the Lord of hosts.
Thank you, Lord.
Those who put me first.
Yes,
those who place me first. Yes, I shall manifest in their lives, says the Lord of hosts.
Yes, God.
And thank you. No, God says, I can do it in a twinkling of an eye.
Yes.
My time is not your time. And we give you praise right now. We give you praise right now, Father. You're great.
Thank you, Lord.
You're awesome, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise you, God. Hallelujah. We praise you, God. There's nothing too hard for God. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, shit, God did it.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, shit, God, what have you put on the back burner, Elder Marvin? What have you put on the back burner? I am God. I come at a moment's notice. What have you placed on the back burner? I don't have to have that right now, but I want this. God said, I can give all things at one given time. Put me at number one. Believe that I can manifest and watch what happens in your life, says the Lord of hosts. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise him. It's not too late. It's not too late. I don't know who's whispering to you. Tell me it's late. It's not too late. I'm God. It's not too late. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give you praise, God. Receive the word of the Lord. Place the Lord first. Put the first things first. The first thing first is God. Put him first in all our ways. Acknowledge him and he will direct our path. Put him first. Hallelujah. Put him first. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. God is good. Oh, God is good. Oh, God is good. Oh, God is good. Oh, God is good. Hallelujah. Oh, my God. We praise you right now, Father. We put you first. We praise you right now, Father. We put you first. We praise you right now. Oh, God. They'll call shit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I hear you, Father. I'm going to ask everybody to unmute right now again. I hear God. Hallelujah. God, I hear you, Father. Come on, let's pray for Love Ministries right now. Everybody, let's open our mouths right now. Come on. We give you praise right now. We thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for moving for Love Ministries right now, God.
Yes.
Thank you for manifesting right now. Yes.
Thank you, God. Manifest right now.
Thank you, Father.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
For manifesting.
Hallelujah.
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 Oh my God.
Hallelujah.
Because you have placed me first, Love Ministries.
You're faithful, God.
I shall manifest.
A faithful God.
I will not withhold. I will not withhold. I will not withhold. I will not withhold. Hallelujah.
Thank you,
come on,
Jesus.
Let's give him a praise. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God.
Bless your name, oh God.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Your name, Jesus.
God is good.
Thank you.
Yes, God, we thank
you. He's good.
Our God, amen.
Yes.
God is good. Hallelujah. I hope you received the word on today. Put in the first things first, which is God. Thank you, Father. And we're going to continue to worship and praise God with our offerings and our tithes. Amen. Y'all, God is good. Hallelujah. As we put him first, let's hear what he has for us in the form of our offering. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We have several ways to give. Amen. At Love Ministries. Amen. Oh, my God, my God, my God. Hallelujah. 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 Several ways to give. Amen. And it's on the screen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, shit. Oh, in my haste this morning. Woo! Hallelujah. My kadose. It bypassed me. If you received Christ this morning and made him first in your heart today, hallelujah, I want you to text born again to 713-849-5683. Amen. And as a result, information will be sent to you. Amen. Y'all, God is good and he's worthy to be praised. Amen.
And I'm just going to interrupt for just a moment.
Amen.
We cannot have received this word from this prophet this morning and not, in addition to sowing into your church, sow into the life of the prophet. Mm. So I want you to put in the memo line. I want everyone to sow an offering into Prophet Roe this morning. I want you to put in the memo line how much of whatever you're sowing is to her, because we want to be a blessing to the woman of God who has blessed our life today. The Lord said, believe in the prophet and you shall prosper. And we want to prosper in everything. Amen. So therefore, we follow the word of God. And we don't want to take for granted that you know to sow into her. Because she's one of ours. Sometimes people have opinions. So therefore, you have received the word of the Lord from the woman of God this day. And in your giving, I want you to add to your giving for her. And then the total amount of what you give to her will be forwarded to her. And we give God praise for her. We give God praise for her. And I turn it right back to you, Prophet Roe.
Thank you, Father. Thank you. Thank you, Father. We praise God. Amen. God is good. And when he kept whispering, just so y'all know, he kept before any sermon, you know, you always check with God. God, what do you want to say? And for maybe 2 weeks, he has been reminding me, I need my people to be reminded to put the first things first. And he is the first thing first. And so anytime that I tried to even replace him with something else, repent, because there is forgiveness. Amen. So I thank God for today. I thank him for just ordering steps. Amen. Because he is awesome in all his ways. Amen. So, Father, we thank you for what you have done and spoken today, Father. We thank you for your presence in this service, Father God. Father, we say, let the peace that surpasses all understanding flow with us like never before, God. Help us, Father, day to day, minute by minute, to never forget that you are first. And putting the first thing first is just putting you first, God. And we give you praise for today. And we say amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Bishop, did you have anything else? Hallelujah. If nothing else?
Not a thing.
Okay. If nothing else? Oh, shit, God. We praise God. Amen. Glory to the God.